to the back garden. Now, this is just going to be a quick sort of introduction and welcome. Currently sitting in the shed because it's freezing outside, and there's nothing much happening out there at the moment. It's Paddy's Day here. I'm based in Ireland, should I say, County Dublin. A little place called Malahide, which is on the coast. So, lovely little place when the weather's good. Windy, cold little place when it's not. So, I'm going to take you out in a wee minute, show you just the back garden. It's very, very small. There's nothing much happening. And to be honest, I've not really done much for this year. Little bit of background, came here at the end of 2016, and it was just mainly a sort of lawn. There was overgrown trees, and I'll show you all that kind of stuff, but I'm just trying to sort of, I've got to remember, we came from the UK, where I had an allotment in Hull in the UK, was the City of Culture last year. Lovely little place. I'm glad I'm out of it, but it was really nice. But I had an allotment for a few years, and when we came here, I still wanted to grow stuff. But I've got to respect that it's still a garden, so you've still got to, you know, dry clothes and, you know, clothing lines, and still be a aesthetically pleasing looking place, and you can't have it like an allotment. So my aim, I never really cracked it last year, and I probably won't crack it this year either, is my aim is to have that sort of happy medium between a garden, an allotment, a growing space, and just somewhere, and it sounds so cliched, but like an additional room. Somewhere you can spend, enjoy, chill out. Okay, so I'll show you about in a wee bit. I'm just going to have a little bit, a cup of coffee or something, because I'm absolutely chilled to the bone. Anyway, let's go. Right, so anyway, this is a small couple of beds in the middle of the garden. Currently got garlic growing away, and yeah, it's doing all right. Took a bit of a battering a couple of weeks ago with the snow. Had quite a bit of frost over the winter as well, but yeah, they're all right. Yeah, wee bit yellow at the end, excuse the wind, but yeah, all right with that. Here's the other one. This bed's been mulched. It's been well fed. A little bit, I think I did it last week, fed it with a little bit of, well, I wanted to get some potash, but some sort of sulfate of potash, but I never had any. The only thing I could do was put in some potato fertiliser, and it's got a good mulching of seaweed. So I plan to do the exact same with this bed. Hopefully this weekend, but we'll see. So coming over to the left hand side of the garden, just saying that, this wee sort of archway thing, and this was from Simon at 50 Shades of Green. He did it in his garden a couple of years ago, I think, and I said, right, I'm going to have one of them, but I end up getting a bit of three. Two here, clipped together, but yeah, great. I grew cucumber up there last year, and it was fantastic, eh? Well, fantastic. I'm saying fantastic, but we don't really like cucumber, so it was a bit of a bummer. This area here, total mud bath, so I've tried to sort of just get the fork in, get a bit of air in there. I've put a whole load of sand down, amazing with the bit of rain that we had during the week there, that the sand seems to have seeped right down. So again, a wee sort of job for this year is get some bit of compost, some grass seed, and just sort of try and get a bit of grass growing there. But anyway, who cares? So let's take you over to the left hand side of the garden. Now, when we came here, as I said, end of 2016, this whole area was just covered in aspics. Been growing, never pruned, never cut back for about 20 years or so. So it was absolutely full of this stuff. But, you know, did you save them? Or in our case, it was a case of just left them, clear it, and try and make a bit of growing space. Again, the areas between the beds is supposed to be grass, but I'll sort that out this year. So, just to, I think I've got a little, don't know if you can see it, a little twig there, which is a redcurrant bush. Wee rosemary that I only put in a few days ago. I feel like I should have maybe have waited until the sort of colder weather had left, but anyway, look at the state of that. Right, there's another one here. These were hanging baskets. End up getting, this is, jute liners, nice natural product. Well, the jackdaws came and just tore the things to shreds. Obviously for nesting or something, but yeah. So, currently get some strawberry, from runners, strawberry runners from last year growing in there. But look at those grey, drab, horrible walls that we're surrounded with. I was thinking about painting them for this year. Try and reflect them, you know. Because what we struggle with is light. For all it's a south-facing garden, obviously, you know, the sun's got to try and get over and into these, over the walls. And I'm thinking, yeah, should I paint them? But I think it'd be more hassle than it's worth painting them. Got a whole load of sort of green algae and all that up them, and yeah, okay, I could sort of scrub all that off, but would it come back? I've no idea. But anyway. So, another little red currant bush. Well, bought that one last summer. And it's grew quite well. Hoping to try and get something out of it this year. This back wall, the left hand side, which I suppose is what we call north west. So it gets no sunshine at all. And never done anything with it. But this year I want to try and get some sort of shade. Bought that fern last year and put it in a bucket, it done great, but with the recent snow and whatever, I don't know if it's killed it off. This thing, I don't know where it is, it was in another part of the garden, and don't know, produces little pink flowers, don't know if you can see. I don't know, stay there for a bit. So, there's my little rhubarb that I only planted just in February sometime, just got it. So it's had a bit of snow on top of it and a bit of ice, but it's sort of peeking through. And this one is big brother, big sister, planted that I think in December. So there's, that's coming on strong, temporarily early. Although, I had to snap this one, this one had sort of snapped off, so it'd get weighed down by the snow, but it'll be alright. Okay, take you over the other side. I'll just say that, this was an apple tree, which had been, I think, in the garden for about 30 odd years or so. So it's a, it was casting so much shade over the garden. So I lopped it off about halfway, and seems to we use it now as a sort of bird feeder, but it ended up that all these branches of them sort of started coming out at the end of last year, so I don't know. And again, from the neighbours, we've got all this ivy. Again, I had to cut all that back when we first came here, because it was right away down the wall. I don't know if you can see any of the remnants from, it come right down the wall, right into the ground, and was sort of growing from the ground, but managed to sort of, it was easy enough to dig up out there, and it, you know, we can contain it at that side. As I said, on this side was sort of raspberries, and over here was all brambles. You couldn't get into this corner, and the big mother root was something, it was a bit down there somewhere. I had to get the pickaxe out, and had to go down about 3 or 4 feet, try to get as much as the sort of taproot out as possible. But you still get bits coming through now and again, but they're sort of manageable. So, okay. So, I'll take you over to the rose bush here. Now, I've never really been into roses, right? And this was, this rose was actually in another part of the garden where the compost bin was, and you couldn't really see it from the kitchen window. So I replanted it last year, and it done all right. You know, it's loads of buds and loads of flowers and whatever. And it's I changed my view on roses. I always thought of them as a bit twee, but these such lovely flowers. But it was the smell. It's a gorgeous smell. So I bought another couple, and when the weather gets a bit better, I want to get them in here. So this has been my work in progress over the winter, this area. I never done anything with it at all last year, and I've been just trying to sort of dig it up when the weather's been alright. But hassle-paying stones. I mean, digging up the other areas of the garden is just full of rubble. This was, I think it was more a sort of dumping ground for rubble, stones. Oh, the amount of stuff I found in it has been unbelievable. In fact, I've got a bucket down there just with sort of plastic debris, and I'll show you what I've had to do with the stones later on. But the bane of my life up above here, and which was the major job when we first came here, was these things from the neighbours. So ivy was alright, but it's these sort of conifer trees. And when we first came here, right over the garden, the shade that they cast and whatever. But so I asked permission from the neighbours. He says, look, can I cut these things back, because they're right over the garden. No problem. Yeah, great. And I feel as if I wish I had cut them back a bit, or down a bit more. Because when you've got sort of, at this time of year, when the sun's just starting to rise a little bit, it's still not rising above them. But, I mean, during the summer it's alright, because it's above them. But then I'm thinking, no, I'm sort of glad we left them at that height, because they meant a lot of birds in there. It is fantastic. So, just take you over to the other side, the garden. And, again, another tree here from the other neighbour. Doesn't look that bad at this time of year. Once it leaves in, the leaves come on, then we sort of, we lose a bit of sort of evening sun during the summer, which is a bit annoying, but hey, we've got to sort of handle these things. So down into these beds, some strawberries that planted last year. Again, another wee scabby looking hanging basket. Of course, new liners that I'm not sure they met, none that Just need to get some compost and to replant them in. And well, I've got some strawberries in there. I think I want to get the strawberries down into this bit. Gets a good bit of morning sun when it's summertime. So you'll get sun from about 5:30 till about, I don't know, about 1:30 in the afternoon. So a good sort of 6 hours. So strawberries in that bed need a bit of work done. As I said, I've not really done much over this winter. Another red currant bush, still looking a bit twiggy. Nothing in here. Again, I've tried to keep the beds, not so much keep them free, but try to build them up. Because obviously, when you sort of first dug them up at the beginning of last year, it's great, and then they sort of, as you grow stuff, they collapse. So I've been trying to build the soil up over the, well, from last autumn to now. And I don't know if you can see a wee red currant bush that I just planted at the end of last year. Still twiggy like. And this is the sort of compost area with a sort of makeshift roof on it. Again, okay, more strawberry runners, a wee bit of lavender there. And that's the canes. I need to try and do something with them canes. I don't know. You know, you just sort of dump them in places. And does not look that great. And just sort of bring you down. Again, more strawberry runners, a couple of cordylines that are fitting lots over the winter. And this is another job. We shut a shed here. Two sheds rather. One was on the right hand side, was used to be oil fired burner, so that's the sort of burner in there. We got gas in just last year, so that's sort of redundant. And this is another shed, but I need to do something with the doors because they've sort of rotted away. So I'll take you up these step ladders just to. So just sort of showed you those beds, the wall there, and just what I've had to dug out. And it's this stones. Look at that. Yeah. They talk about no dig. Sometimes you've got to, because you can't grow through that. Anyway, quick wee tour. And I'll see you again. Thanks.